All right, guys, I've got this 24V Tige. I believe this is a 2004 model. The owner of this boat would like to get the ballast bags that are in it plumbed up. We're gonna add a ballast bag. He's been filling them with a little cigarette plug pump and just tired of sitting around on the lake waiting on the bags to fill and empty. And so I'm gonna show you guys how to install ballast bags, how to take the big step of drilling the holes in the boat, how to get it plumbed and wired up. So follow along, we're gonna do it. I want to explain to you guys a little bit about what a ballast system is in a boat. So these boats, the wakeboard boats, are made to entertain the guy behind the boat, right? The guy or the gal. And so we pull a skier or we pull a wakeboarder, or more recently we surf, and it's all about what's happening behind the boat. So in recent years, as surfing's become more popular, people have begun to add weight to the back of the boats, or ballast. So they have these bags that fill with water. If you're watching this video to figure out how to install these in your boat, you probably know what I'm talking about. So I want to lay out the basic components of the system for those that are maybe just trying to figure this out. So the basic components would be bags that hold water or weight in the boat, pumps that fill the bags with water, and switches that turn the pumps on and off. And then we need to have some holes in the boat basically to allow the water to come in and out. So throughout this video, I'm gonna get pretty in-depth showing you guys how to do this so that you can do your own boat or know what's going on if you have somebody doing it for you.
Kind of figured out what the boat needed. Then we got on wakemakers.com and ordered some supplies. So I've got the box from Wakemakers opened up here, and I wanna show you what all we got. So right here, we got a ballast bag. This one's gonna go under the seat on the left side. The owner of this boat already had bags for the back corners. We've got three pumps, so we're going to be able to fill the front bag or the back bag on the left or right is the idea with three pumps. And Wakemakers makes these wiring harness kits. You use this connection to the battery, and then you run a wire. It's one of these two. I'm not sure which one yet, but you run the power wire basically to the switch. Here's the switches we got bought. So we're going to have three switches, one for each of the pumps. Anyways, run a wire to the switch and then a wire back from the switch to the pump. And you'll be able to individually turn each of the three pumps on. And what's cool about these switches is they come with a label. So you've got right, left, and front. You can buy pretty much whatever labels you might need on the website. These are the switch bodies, or the plugs themselves that go into the bodies there. And then you've got the part that everyone's always scared about, drilling a hole in the bottom of the boat. But we've got a couple fittings and a valve. And some silicone, that's important. And then these are the vents to where the air will come out of the bag, and I'll show you how all this is gonna work when we get there. So I removed the screws and the dash panel here, and there's three switches right in a row that weren't being used. Docking lights, which this boat doesn't have. Fore and aft tower lights, which it also doesn't have. And shower, which it does not have. So what I've done is take this loose and unplug the wires off the back and just pop these switches out. Snap the switch housings into this plate and simply put these covers on. Snap right into place. So we've got left, which is left rear, right rear, and front. Empty, fill. And I'm going to take this part of the wiring harness and plug it onto the back. All right, so I'm working on running the wiring harnesses now that we got the switches in. So I've got the first one in here, and I'm going to show you what it did. So I've got the wires thrown down in here. This end that goes to the pump motor. I'll stick up through the back like this. And the other end I'm going to stick up through here. It's kind of dark probably, but basically it's going to run in this nook here behind the seat. Run like this up, and I'll plug it in into the dash. So the ballast bag that I bought, that's a long rectangle, fits here under this seat. The other two that the owner of this boat already had are square bags that sit back here in the back. So we got one in this locker. The other one will go over here in this locker. My plan is to mount the pumps back here in the back. It's got this little nook by the transom. This side was wide open. There is a little hydraulic pump back there that's
out of the way. Batteries are on this side, so we'll grab power from those, bring it over, run it up to the switches and back to these pumps, and we'll be able to mount the main valve, the hole through the bottom of the boat, about right in here in front of the engine. What I'm working. So on this side of the boat, there's already a drain or an outlet here for the bilge pump, and it just happens to be the same size hose right here, 3/4 inch ID hose, that we're going to use for the bags, for the plumbing on the bags. So I'm hoping to just tee into that for the vent and the overflow drain for this bag. And then the piece that I bought from Wake Makers is identical to that. So we're going to put this on the other side. So over here now on the left side of the boat, I've measured out, marked it out right here where we're going to put this, and it's going to poke through on the inside, and this will match the vent on the other side. I'm going to start with a pilot hole and then move to a hole saw bit. Now we're committed. Got a hole in the boat. I drilled 1 1/8 inch hole. This one has the elbow fitting on it. This goes like this, fits in there nice. What I'm gonna do is come on the inside and actually cut the carpet back a little bit so that when I tighten the nut up, I can get a little tighter fit on it. Now it's time to drill the big daddy. This is a 2-inch brass fitting. It's gonna go through the bottom of the boat. Got a 2-inch hole saw. So I'm gonna do it the same way I did the vent in the side. I'm gonna start with a little pilot hole, make sure everything's lined up how I want, and then we'll drill the big one. Let's check it out. So I'm gonna crawl under the boat here, take a peek at what we've got to decide where we wanna put this big hole at. So you'll see right here, this is the water pickup for the engine. It's got a little brass cover over it. What we wanna watch is that we don't hit one of these stringers that the trailer sits on, or like a molded profile on the bottom of the boat. We want a nice, smooth, flat spot so we have a good seal. So I think my goal is gonna be to go right behind that engine pickup, somewhere in that neighborhood. We'll look inside and see what we've got. All right, so I'm standing here beside the engine. As you've noticed, this is a V-drive boat, and so the engine's in here backwards. This is the rear of the engine, which is towards the front of the boat. And the water pickup for the engine, if I can get you to see it here, we just looked at it underneath, and right there it is. It'll focus here inside the boat. And it's a little bit tight if we look back, set up under the engine. We don't really want to go that way. We want to go where we've got plenty of room to put the fitting and the elbow. This is the elbow lane here that we're going to be putting on the fitting. Here in a valve. The valve is very important. I'll show you that in a bit. Anyways, we're going to shoot for right down here. It's nice and flat, and there's room to get to it. We'll get some measurements, see what we can come up with. So we are laying under the boat here. I've just measured out. This is the water pickup we looked at inside, and I've measured out going forward 8 inches. And I don't know if you can tell, but I'm just towards the inside of the boat a little bit, because it's there starts to be a little bit of contour in the hull, and we want to kind of avoid that. We want a nice flat spot. Well, here it goes. I'm gonna make a hole. This is a pilot hole. Up here in the boat, you can see the little pile of sawdust, fiberglass dust. That is the remnants of the pilot hole poking through. The nice part about doing the little pilot hole is it gives you a little bit of wiggle. Obviously, you got to be close. You want to double check your measurements, but we are we're in the right spot. You know, you could be off up to 2 inches maybe and move it over if you needed to with the pilot hole method. All right, let's drill the big one. I can see the shop floor. I have 3M marine vinyl sealant. This is white. You can get it in white, clear, maybe other colors, I don't know. This is where you don't want to go sparingly. We want to put plenty on. We're going to put it all around this fitting, and I'll show you a little trick to hold this in place by yourself while you tighten it up.
I'm gonna put it all around here, and I'm gonna put a little bit on that first section of threads.
All right, got this thing loaded down with silicone. I'm gonna show you a little trick that I came up with to do this by yourself. Let's see here. Hopefully I can do all this while holding the camera. This goes in. Or have some squeeze out. I'm gonna set the camera down just a second. Okay, now I've got it back in place. So you can see here I've got a piece of wood that I've cut as a prop. And I've got it on the axle. I'm using that to wedge it in place. And we're gonna crawl up in the boat and put the nut on.
So inside the boat now, sitting in the engine compartment, you can see we had a nice little bit of silicone squeeze out. I brought the tube up here with me. I thought I might put some more on it, but I might do a little bit. I'm gonna put some more around that and then put the nut on. All right, it's siliconed up so the water won't leak out. I mean, won't leak in. The fitting through the bottom of the hull has had time to dry. Now the silicone glue on that and sealant there is dry. And so we've got the elbow on top, and then we've got this brass valve. And the valve is very important because if you're gonna leave your boat in the water for a long period of time, you can shut it. That way, if something was to spring a leak when you weren't around, you'd be able to not have a bunch of water running in the boat. So you'd have it open when you're in use and closed when it's sitting for a while. Just a little safety mechanism. Then we go to a barbed fitting here. And what I'm gonna put on the end of that fitting then is an 1.5-inch hose that is gonna run back here to the back of the motor, where we're gonna have a little distribution block that goes to the pumps. And I'll show you that here in just a second. Okay, I've got the main hose ran here. I wanna show you. The main 1.5-inch rubber hose is coming just off the valve, runs underneath the engine. What I did with this setup was came back here to a T. Basically a T, it's a cross. And then it comes out of that three ways with this 3/4-inch rubber hose and goes to the three pumps, which I've got mounted right here. So we've got the 1.5-inch feeding 3/3 feeding the pumps. And then I just hooked up the first bag. So this one, water's gonna come in here, come out there and go to the bag. Get ready to hook up this one, which will head to the next bag. Okay, we got the bags in. If you can see down in here, I got the bag here on the left side and it's plumbed up. Bag in the back left. And the vents for both come, they tee together and go out this one. Back right, right here, comes up and it's actually teeing into the bilge pump vent. So it will dump out that way. I've got the wire still loose here. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take it out, put this thing on the water, and then check the polarity and match up the correct switches for the correct pump. All right, we just test ran the first pump. We figured out that one's back right and that these wires go to it. So we did the polarity deal, got it running the right way for fill and empty. Had to reverse it one time to get it right. Here in a bit, once we get the other three figured out, I'll cut the wires to length and solder them. We've got the engine running, so we're making good amperage, keeping the batteries charged because these things have a pretty good draw. We're filling the back left and the front, what we call the front here. We're gonna fill them up, see if we got any leaks, and see how our overflow vents work. So the ballast bag installation is done. We just pulled the boat out of the pond. And you can see here where it dumps the water out the bottom. If you got any water left in the bags, it's kinda cool. Okay, I have shortened all the wires, make them no longer than they need to be, and soldered the connections. I'm gonna tidy these wires up like this. Try to make a nice, neat little wiring job here. Pumps are now labeled back left, front left, and back right as to what tank they go to. We're gonna wrap this thing up. I wanna show you what the switches on the dash that I installed look like. So if you look right here, I removed three of the original OEM switches that were up here on the dash of this boat. They were not being used. This boat had options that this particular boat didn't come with from the factory. And so we had three unused switches. So I had these that I bought from Wake Makers. And you can see here, we've got left, front, and right. And so now if you're on the lake enjoying your time on the water and you wanna switch water activities, you wanna add a little weight to the back for wakeboarding after you get done skiing, or you wanna go from wakeboarding to surfing, you don't have to take time to stop and fill your bag with a tiny little pump.
Now it's as simple as just flipping a switch. Hope you guys enjoyed checking out this installation video for the wake ballast system in this boat. If you like what you see, be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. Thanks, guys.